Okay, oh boy, where to even start here? You know, I'm just gonna say before I even get into this video, I keep it 100 on here. I don't believe in sugarcoating the truth, especially when it comes to the movie and the movie business. It's not healthy for anybody involved. I am probably outside of the demographic for this movie. And I also happen to agree with director Sophia Takel that, you know, the horror genre can absolutely open up to a younger audience in a different demographic without sacrificing what makes the genre great or what makes, you know, horror and slasher movies great. My point being is that I don't have a problem with the movie being PG-13. There's nothing wrong. Plenty of PG-13 horror films have come out, and they stand amongst the best. Not every audience member or every moviegoer has to like the same movie. It's fine. But what movies don't get to do is, and what directors don't get to do, is use a PG-13 rating and targeting a younger demographic to excuse poor character development and poor writing and mediocre plotting. And also, I want to take this a step further and say that the horror genre, as I can see it, has always celebrated women. It has always been a beacon for strong female characters. The main trope of the slasher genre is called the final girl for a reason. You have so many examples of strong, powerful women on camera making strides in the industry. There is Sigourney Weaver with Aliens, you know, Ellen Ripley, Linda Hamilton with the Terminator franchise is more science fiction, but the first film definitely was like a horror film. There's Laurie Strode, there's Sidney Prescott, there's Pamela Voorhees. On the other side of that, you have great directors like Mary Lambert, who got her start within the horror genre with the first two Pet Sematary movies. And you also have figures like Verna Fields, who was one of the most prolific women within the industry, I believe. You know, she was the editor on Jaws, and her work on that film, I believe it won an Oscar, it was nominated for an Oscar. Her work on that film, the editing in that film, is one of the key factors in that movie being as great as it is. And there was even at one point consideration for her being the director of Jaws 2. And then there's a great female composer by the name of Shirley Jackson. May you rest in peace. You know, she was a very prolific composer. She worked with John Carpenter on some of his later films, and she provided the score for the Final Destination series up until her death. It just goes to show you that the horror genre has always been a beacon for women, I think. And even though it has been predominantly driven by the male gaze and male directors, they've always celebrated women and powerful women being at the forefront. They've always been the ones that have taken on the killer at the end and lived to tell the tale. There have been many examples of them being the villains themselves. Catherine Tremell from Basic Instinct, Sharon Stone comes to mind yet again. My point in all of this is just to say that I understand where the filmmakers and the producers behind this project were coming from, and however misguided they were, their intentions were good. That being said, Black Christmas 2019 is just such a deeply unsatisfying and almost insulting and offensive piece of work, especially to the horror genre and the horror fans that have stayed behind in this particular subgenre for so long. And it just completely fails in delivering any sort of compelling social message outside of men hate women and colleges suck, which anybody who's gone to a college in the past 20 years could probably tell you that last one. You know, before I go any further, I always want to start with what I liked first. And this movie, it wasn't completely awful. It did have a couple of things that I did like. I mean, first and foremost, production values are pretty good. I mean, they were on par, I think, for a Blumhouse film. Nothing really stood out to me as looking too cheap or too fake. The lead actress, Imogen Poots, I thought she did a really good job, serviceable job, I should say. I bought her character. Most of her dialogue wasn't horrible, and she did have a somewhat compelling arc, and was the only character I really kind of identified with or even felt an ounce of sympathy for. I'm also a sucker when it comes to holiday settings and horror films. I believe there is so much potential with the themes of Christmas and just the light and the color palette that comes with the holidays to do something really special and unique with the genre. Not that the producers here do anything like that. Everything that I saw was pretty much done before in a holiday horror film with the colors and lights and everything. I do appreciate and I do like that visual aesthetic within a film, so the film does get some props for me for doing that. And there's maybe one or two scenes here where I did feel like there was some suspense or there was a good jump scare. But outside of those elements, I don't feel like anything in this movie was particularly well done, well acted, well executed. It fails in comparison, definitely, to the first Black Christmas. I can't tell you how many times I looked up from my phone, or I looked at the time, or went to the bathroom, or I was otherwise distracted from the runtime in the movie. And that is the worst possible thing that you can do with a moviegoer in the theater, is distract them from the screen. From the opening moments of the film, I was completely just flustered and irritated by the dumb decision-making, the dumb characters, the dumb dialogue. Every bit of dialogue that comes out of someone's mouth in this film is 75% of it is social politics, and it just comes across as just incredibly preachy. It doesn't feel genuine at all. It feels definitely like this is a politically agenda driven film, outside of it just shamelessly using a pre-existing IP to sell tickets. It feels like it was a movie that was made specifically for the creation of this message. And look, I'm not trying to say that feminism or toxic masculinity or anything like that is not real and shouldn't be talked about. Absolutely, bring it up in movies, talk about it. Movies are one of the best ways to talk about these kinds of things because it gets people together like almost anything else. Art in general brings people together more than anything else in the world, I feel like, besides politics. And, you know, politics also drives people apart, and art, as we've seen lately, can also drive people apart. But I do feel like there was room for an even mixture of those. However, this movie does not achieve that mixture at all. It is so all over the place. I mean, every single word about social politics that came out of someone's mouth in this movie, it felt like it was being spoken from a 70-year-old professor who has tenure, who doesn't give a shit about what they're talking about, and is only saying what they're saying because they know that they can get away with it. It was just so preachy and cringy how every single time, at every opportunity, the women of this film made men into the enemy, the absolute worst enemy. But the movie also goes out of its way to justify a lot of these plot points in the message and the theme of this film. There was, for one example, there was only about one male character in this film that I would consider to be halfway decent. But even all throughout the runtime, his behavior and jokes and his very being is just questioned and is portrayed as being shady or suspicious or weird by many of the characters. And then at the end of the film, they almost completely ruin his character by making him one of the villains for a couple of minutes. And it's only through the power of love or some other corny shit that he's able to come back to the side of good. And it also doesn't help that this character is also the only male character of color in the film. All the other males in the film are all these white, privileged frat bros. I mean, like I said, the movie has absolutely no subtlety and no nuance in conveying this message at all. And like I said before, it's even more frustrating given just how powerful the feminism and text and themes of the first Black Christmas and even the 2006 remake. I'm not going to talk about that very much, but you know, both of those two films I feel like did a much better job. The original film specifically, they did a much better job of conveying this feminist tone and theme. I mean, it's a classic of the genre for a reason, and I feel like just completely missed the mark and missed what made the first Black Christmas so special. And please, 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 please don't come at me with they were going after toxic masculinity, which I know. My head still hurts with how many times they beat me with that in the film, okay? I get the message that they were trying to convey. I get the tone. I truly understand. But my point is that there was just no subtlety to it, and it was so one-sided. And the film goes out of its way to justify all of those themes. And it just doesn't make any sense to me, given the history of the horror genre, the history of the slasher genre, and this particular movie that they've decided to remake yet again. It just doesn't make sense for them to come across as so preachy and ultra SJW liberal type dialogue when the fan base that has supported these movies and has treasured these movies so much is predominantly male. I'm gonna say it. I mean, horror definitely is very popular with women, of course, but in my experience, it has been the male audience that has really driven this specific subgenre for so many years, and to completely discredit them and toss them to the side and insult them to their face, and telling them that they should just take the abuse because they have all the power, it sends a message that the filmmakers here don't seem to be looking for equality. They're just looking to say that women are better and men suck. And it goes beyond that too. Just every single character in the movie besides the main character, and the main character is also guilty of this as well, but almost every single character in the film is just so frustratingly stupid. Like the opening kill of the movie, the girl goes from house to house. She's screaming, you know, once let me in, and then as soon as that doesn't work, she immediately forgets that there's a killer in the area and just starts looking all scared and whatnot, not paying attention to her surroundings at all, not making any sort of valiant attempt to fight back or call for help until it's absolutely too late. She deserved every minute of pain she got for being so stupid, and I'm just gonna say it, okay? Almost every single character in this movie deserved their fate because they were so stupid. And that has nothing to do with them being women. I'd say the same thing if this was a co-ed cast. I'd say the same thing if this was any other movie. Like I said, I keep it 100%. I'm not going to mince words here, okay? This movie just failed. It completely failed on what it was trying to do, on the messages it was trying to convey, and the type of genre it was trying to emulate and be. PG-13 slashers can work. Happy Death Day is the only example I can think of off the top of my head, but that movie was very successful in being a PG-13 slasher and also having a good story, feminist tones, everything that this movie did not achieve. And as for the whole, like, killer subplot, I don't even know what to say about that. It was just so dumb. It was so stupid. I mean, not only was it completely spoiled for me in the trailers. The trailers practically gave you everything. If you saw the trailer, you saw this movie. No need to see it. There's like one or two things that they don't give away, but it's just so predictable and so stupid. It feels like a writer who never seen a horror movie before, who has never watched a slasher film before, went onto TVTropes.com, looked up the page for slasher films, and then tried to write a script with every single one of those tropes in mind. And it just doesn't work at all. It's so dumb. Who wrote this? Who came up with this idea? Oh, it was the director who wrote it. Well, I guess that makes sense then. It's maddening to me to see a beloved horror IP like Black Christmas being drug out of the dirt to be remade yet again for the second time, and then there just be no wit, no sophistication, no nuance to any of the plot or theme or any of the stuff that they're trying to convey here. It is so lazy and so cynical that they would use Black Christmas to sell this movie. And Black Christmas is definitely a classic within the genre, but it's not like a huge IP. It's not like Halloween or Nightmare on Elm Street or even like The Fog or any of these other movies that came out and did good business and that there is a good reason for them to be remade. No, this movie came out, was a cult classic, didn't really get a whole lot of attention outside of that, was remade for the first time in 2006 and flopped then. So I don't know who approved this project behind the scenes at Blumhouse, thinking that it was going to be anything other than a bomb. And honestly, that is my biggest problem with this movie. I could handle the preachy SJW politics. I could handle the amateur production values and directing and acting. I could handle all of that if the movie had just been named something else and had done its own thing. But no, by using a name like Black Christmas, you're just cynically trying to attract in the very audience that your movie is actively making fun of. Like, I get that this movie was trying to attract a female, younger demographic as well, but this is a horror film. It's a remake of a very classic horror film. Male audience members are gonna wanna go see it, okay? And then when they go see the movie, they feel insulted. They feel like the filmmaker and the producers don't respect them as people. And what did you think was going to happen? And yeah, I get that this is just, you know, a low-budget slasher film, but no, when it's tied to a movie like the original Black Christmas, I am absolutely going to hold it up to that standard. And it doesn't even meet the standard met by the 2006 version. It's lazy cash grabs like 2019's Black Christmas that just put me off of, you know, revisiting IPs and just put me more and more on the cynical viewpoint that I have of Hollywood now. To be honest, I'm glad that this movie's flopping with audiences. I'm glad that this movie's flopping at the box office, okay? It doesn't need to make money. It doesn't deserve good reviews. It doesn't deserve praise because it is lazy, cynical, and it's insulting. Whew. All right, well, thank you so much for joining me today. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please comment below. Tell me what you thought about the movie. Let's start the conversation here now. What are some of your favorite holiday horror films? I would love to know. I'd love to get a list together. Maybe try to review another one before the holiday season's over. As always, I love you guys. You guys take care of yourselves. Be safe. Be true to yourself. And as always, I will see you all again here real soon.